One, two, three, four, five. All right.
Hi, Mr. K.
Oh, hi, Tambor. How are you?
I'm well, thank you.
It's nice to see you.
What are you doing?
I'm writing a musical staff here because I want to write a scale.
Oh, I know what a scale is.
You do?
Oh, yeah. I weighed myself on one today.
Some scales measure weight.
Oh, not that kind of scale.
Wait, oh, I know what a scale is.
You do?
I had scales on the fish I caught.
Some scales are on a fish's skin.
Not that kind of scale. The kind of scale that we use in music is made up of musical pitches.
Oh, like baseball?
No. In music, pitches are high notes and low notes.
Okay.
Well, for instance, a high pitch would be like,
oh. Okay.
And a low pitch would be like, oh.
I see.
So when I write notes way up on the here on the staff, those are high notes. I could put a really high note. I can even add lines, go way up there. Or I can put lines down below the staff to make them really low. High notes are up here, low notes are down there.
Musical scales are made from pitches, from low to high or high to low.
How do you know all this stuff?
Well, every morning I come in and I ask myself how I'm going to teach music. And I'm not the first music teacher to do that.
Teaching music is hard.
And there was a guy a long time ago, Guido of Arezzo. He was a monk in a big church called the Notre Dame Cathedral. And 1,000 years ago, he came up with a way of teaching scales.
We call it the Guidonian hand. He would point to his hand, and the children would sing different notes of the scale. Each note had a special little word that went with it that was borrowed from a song written in an ancient language. Here is the song. And now, 1,000 years later, we still teach scales using the same words that Guido of Arezzo used on his hand so many years ago.
Oh, I don't know if I can remember those words. They're not even in English.
Well, there was a woman, Maria, who taught some kids the scale and the words that go with them by using English words that sound kind of like them. Check it out.
Re, mi, fa, so, la, ti. Oh, let's see if I can make it easier. Doe, a deer, a female deer. Ray, a drop of golden sun. Me, a name I call myself. Far, a long, long way to run. So, a needle pulling thread. La, a note to follow so. Tea, a drink with jam and bread. That will bring us back to dough. Oh, oh, oh,
dough!
A deer, a female deer.
Hooray!
A drop of golden sun.
Hey!
A name I call myself.
Bah!
A long, long way to run.
So,
a needle pulling thread.
La,
a note to follow so. Bring us back to dough.
A deer, a female deer. Ray, a drop of golden sun. Me, a name I call myself. Long,
that will bring us back to do. Do, re, mi, fa, so, la, di, do, so, do.
So, Tambor, did you see how Maria tried to take those words that were from a different language and make them into English words?
Oh, yeah, like, I know a doe is a deer and a ray is sunlight and me, myself. But what is fa, a long, long way to run? I don't get it.
That's a funny one because, well, if I park my car and have a yard, that would be fa, fa away from here. Fa, a long, long way to run.
You mean far? That's fa, far. I get it. That's hilarious.
So you see, Tambor, scales have been around for a long time, and there's some easy ways for us to learn to sing them.
Yeah, I still think it's kind of hard.
Oh, it's not too bad. Listen to the Jackson 5 tell you about it.